Brony Geeks proudly presents What's the Topic? Marvel's Hawkeye. The following audio may contain coarse language and other materials that may not be for a younger audience. The opinions expressed in this audio are solely those of the speakers involved. These conversations may contain spoilers of current media such as games, comics, movies, television shows, and more. Grown-up Geeks makes no claim to ownership of various media discussed, simply the opinions expressed. Listener discretion is advised. Hey guys, be sure to swing by the Facebook group. No spoilers till Monday. Spider-Man No Way Home. We will have a recap shortly. We'll try to get everyone's schedules involved. Be sure to bring yourself over to the YouTube page, which is likely where you found this video. 164 subscribers. Hit that beautiful red subscribe button. We appreciate it. And any likes help the page moving forward. And also check out audio content on anchor.fm/groaninggeeks. And without further ado, Marvel's Hawkeye. Got your host, Dickaroni with cheese, the amazing spider spam up top, the man, the myth, the Marvel, running this bitch, Will Parker. How are we doing, gentlemen?
I just woke up.
Same.
I think we all just woke up.
Sleeping in is a grown ape geek's proud trait.
Hey, man.
Especially when you get old.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm right. Also West Coast time, so I got up at 7 a.m. Just so we can record some amazing content with you guys.
Wasted on crayons.
Did you really waste some crayons on the floor? That's what you're looking at? I'm mad at you.
Sure.
The joys of working with Marines, ladies and gentlemen.
I can see Will late at night take a count 64 like people do money, throw that shit up in the air, just roll around in it. I can see it.
I don't know why you're envisioning Will doing this, but
I can see it.
The less questions I ask, the better it goes for me.
You want to know what he was wearing?
Nope. Will, what were your thoughts episodes 3 through 5? You can kind of give it like a small little breakdown. We'll get to those thoughts.
I mean, I'm going to keep it simple. It was a fantastic setup and stuff like that. Freaking for the reveal that it went into and stuff like that. I saw it kind of leading to bigger stuff. And again, the payoff freaking hit in more ways than one. And so with that, and without me giving any spoilers and stuff,
you can
like
give
that,
it away.
No, not for what I want to give it away for. So with that, like, things are just working as they should, and I'm very happy about it. You guys will know when we have other conversations later what I'm talking about.
Just trust me.
I don't like not knowing. Well, I mean, overall as a series, this is one of my favorite ones. Of course, you have your slow episode, which for me was 3. The rest of them were all better than 3, but I understand you got to have that one that, okay, let's take a step back and then we start back up. Not like WandaVision. Like Will said, the payoff at the end, I was like, okay, I kind of figured it was going to be something big. I didn't realize it was going to be a merge that big. Which I'm excited for because I guess I can go ahead and say it, right? You good?
Yeah.
Daredevil is one of my favorite shows. I loved it. I love all of it. I love how it was set up. I love the Kingpin. Everything about that show I love. And for now, for them to bring that part of the universe and say, hey, this is happening at the same time in the same area. I love that. I want to see how Daredevil and Hawkeye work out. That's a dynamic that I really want to see because I like the dynamic of Hawkeye and Hawkeye Jr., as I like calling her. I like their dynamics. She seems more like a daughter to him than his real one, which I understand it still, you know, Kate has her own thing going on, but I like the aspect that he's still reeling over the fact from Natasha's death, and he sees that possibly happen again with Kate, and that's one thing he doesn't want to happen. We all knew that Yelena was going to be brought in at some point. I love that fight scene between all four of them
on the rooftop.
On the rooftop, all four of them. Because I was like, okay, you're fighting a widow. But how are y'all fighting? And it was like, how are you fighting the same person? And the real came out like, yep. I was like, yep, let's get into it. And then they started fighting. And then when K Kate drew down on Elena, and Elena was like, don't do it. Like, don't do it. You don't want this smoke. And then I'm rambling. Go ahead. Your turn, Brent. I'm gonna take it all if I keep talking. I mean, I loved it. It was great. It was.
Because this is one of your favorite Marvel TV shows to date.
Yes, that and Daredevil.
Okay. Because Loki was probably my favorite, and then WandaVision was pretty close second.
No, what? I have WandaVision right around Luke Cage. But above Iron Fist, if that's anything.
That's not saying much. But anyway, episode 3, like you're saying. God. God, that was bad.
Hey.
You simmer down up there. You keep your shenanigans to a minimum. You just had your shenanigan tirade.
I was about to. All
right. Episode 4 and episode 5 brought me right back into the show. I still hate that a lot of TV shows play that pronoun game when they're like talking about the big bad. Don't worry about him. I'm worried about him. I'm worried about her. Bruh, come out and say it with your chest. Say who you're worried about. No one's just going to sit there in a logical conversation and be like, I'm worried about him. And be like, not ask him who. I need some level of clarity. But we got it at the big reveal at the end of episode 5. Yo.
I will say that I liked it just for the suspense dynamic of it. But I will agree, after a while, it's like, okay, who the fuck are you talking about now? This is, I need to know now.
I'm so nosy. I need answers. I'm one of those people. I will proudly say that. I want to know. And it's nice that they got me to be like, almost yelling at the TV. Who are we talking about? What is going on?
I will say, yeah, they worked that episode. I was like, yeah.
Yeah.
I still love DC, though, so. But right now, it's all about Marvel.
I will say, though, the Wish version of Jon Snow is not doing it for me on TV. He looks like he messed around on 2K, got some BC, spent no money on stats, spent it all on tattoos. You're like, bro.
I will like the reveal that now she knows that he set her dad up.
Because that's going to be a fun dynamic unraveling. It feels a lot like Falcon and Winter Soldier. Like, that yes. Unraveling of that group slowly but surely having that big moment there. And, I mean, Florence Pugh, come on. Let's give it up to her. That whole macaroni scene was one of the funniest things I've seen in a long time.
Just, it's like, commentary. He's sitting there and she was like, Eric, she's got K. Bishop. So why do you say my entire name all the time? It's like a parent scolding the child. It's like, and then she started laughing like, I could have beat you. And she talked about the rooftop fight. I said, you could have what? That's pretty funny.
You're funny.
That's
the thing that I like about Kate Bishop is that is like she recognizes her place, and so she's not like larger than life, like, oh, I'm in this thing. So like she knows, like, nah, you could have killed me like right before I walked in the door. Like, fuck it, I'd have been gone. Yep, okay. So I'm gonna sit down and have this conversation with you because there's no point in me trying to get into it. So the fact that she recognizes where she's at and where she's trying to get to, so that is good for her character development. So that, mm-hmm. And I will definitely say that her archery skills are on point in terms of, like, I've been watching a couple of videos so that about them rating freaking archery skills so that and what she's actually doing. So that, like, yo, she's definitely doing a damn thing as far as, like, you know, how Hawkeye went through the proper training and so that to learn how to shoot the bow. Like, she definitely went through it. I think she's definitely doing better. And I don't know if that's just her in particular, or if they're actually setting it up for the show because she's a really good archer and just making her better than Hawkeye, but I feel like that's where she's going to get to.
I mean, like, she does get better eventually.
Yeah, she does get better, but for like just the evolution of her, we see it all throughout the show when she starts off with her initial, I want to get a bow, and then it's just going and stuff like that from there. And
that quarter trick, though.
That shit was great because he was. He was just talking, and she was just talking shit. He was like, I can hit whatever I want. No, you can't die. You think I'm going to have people say, I just don't believe. He was like, what? Bing! it was like nonstop. I'm like, do your thing.
I don't know how they pulled off that stunt or if that was even like fake or whatnot. I don't even care. That was impressive shit.
Anybody try that besides me?
I tried. I'm not ashamed. I just hit a wall and like I put a dent. Like
I try. I've been doing that with a pin. I've been trying to hit my kids forever and it just don't work. But I think the first I got was like 4 feet. So
having said with how great we think overall the series is going, Tony, what are you looking forward to most in the next couple of episodes?
Daredevil.
One word answer.
That's I'm it. Here for it. That's it. That's all I want.
Just say if Daredevil. You want Charlie Cox. Just
I want no. I want a Daredevil Hawkeye brawl. I want it.
No.
I don't know. I want that.
No.
You really want to see Hawkeye beaten that badly?
I want to see that. Yes.
No.
Yes, I do. No, look, I already know Daredevil was put the hands on Hawkeye. I understand
that. I mean, yeah, but no. I
understand that. I want it. No, maybe want it. Look, Electra just we don't,
shows up, beats everybody's ass. It's fine.
Look, not we don't want it to the point where, you know, Clint is incapacitated, has to get frozen vegetables and put it all over his body anymore. We don't want that. I still need, like, give me a little tease, like, you know, baton comes flying out the air and Clint catches it. And then they just start going at it for like 5 minutes, you know.
Well, what are you looking forward to?
That's what I want.
That. Well, we only got, one episode left. Let's let that. Yes. And this next episode is supposed to have a runtime of about 59 minutes, supposedly. So we're going to get a lot in this thing, so like that. And I think Daredevil would detract from the story and stuff like that. Like, we got Kingpin and Flash. Honestly, I don't want, like, I'll take Kingpin like you, but I don't want Kingpin, like, involved in, like, no fighting and nothing like that. I don't want Daredevil in there, so like that, because I don't want to take away from the story of,
like, Kate season Bishop two.
And stuff like that. The season two, they do a season two, so like that. Yeah, I'm all for it, stuff like that. Because you gotta remember, we're setting up like the Young Avengers in this bitch and stuff like that. Like, there's so many things going and stuff like that. And you could give me a cameo freaking where she bumps into freaking, you know, Miss Marvel on the street or something like that, or whatever case may be. And it's just like, oh, cool. Well, there's a little Easter egg and kind of a setup or whatever the case may be. I'll take something like that over, you know, Daredevil making an appearance, because he's just gonna run the fucking gauntlet, because we know how Daredevil does. So it's like, we can't have that here. Freaking, okay. he's gonna take over. The show's not gonna be called Hawkeye no more. All right.
The blind guy and the guy with the bow and arrow.
It'd be called Hawk. Ah.
<He's stupid. laughs> So unnecessary.
It's such never a unnecessary
good video until now. Just
how? Wait, oh, what's wrong with y'all? That was a great. Shut up.
We appreciate you, but we can't support your shenanigans too loudly.
Fine. Look, hey, can I just say one of my favorite scenes?
Yes, absolutely.
When Yelena was in the mirror in her friends, you know, they had just went to the other widow try to get her, and then she was in the mirror, and then her ass disappeared and came right back, and that showed the effects of the snap. Because I know we was all thinking, like, what the fuck did they go through? Did they know they were gone for that long? And then when she came out and said, I was only in there for 5 seconds. What the fuck? And it's been 5 years. I loved how they put that in there to give some closure to people like me. I was like, I need to know what happened to y'all. Did y'all know y'all were gone? What? Tell me what went on. And I just appreciated that. That was one of my favorite, because then she disappeared and it's almost an instant comeback, because you're like, wait a minute, why is the water going through her hands? And then you see ash and then reformation and then everything changes around. I love that. I love it. Okay, go.
Yeah, my favorite like scene said, is just that whole macaroni and cheese scene. Like, that for me was funny. Any scene with Florence Pugh, I'm 100% for. I think she's doing a great job of owning her character, owning the role. The accent kind of comes in and out from time to time, so I'm a little But at the same time, like, I've heard worse, and I know Marvel will have a payoff for it, so I'm not going to sit here and be like, this is going to be terrible. They know what they're doing. I have to trust the process, even if episode 3
was It's a sexy accent.
Shannon. How many crayons you been eating? We'll get on this before he does something crazy.
Six. I think my favorite scene is kind of a hustle. It has to be where the conversations with Hawkeye and stuff like that. The conversation he has himself, he takes the earpiece out and he really focuses on Widow. We kind of get a proper freaking, you know, goodbye. Send off for Widow and stuff like that. Cause we got it for Tony, but we didn't really get it for Widow. She just kind of died. So it was like, we get a little something there, and I'm very happy for that. And that moment when he talks to his wife and stuff like that, and she's like, yo, you don't need my permission. You do what you gotta do. And knowing that freaking he has, you know, she understands that he has higher responsibilities, so that for taking care of people and stuff like that, and being that understanding is fantastic. Like, she's been his ace freaking since day one and stuff like that. So, and the fact that she knows everything that's going on, so that, and she can like check stuff and everything like that, like, yo, how much shit was she into and stuff like that? Like, well, how did they meet? What's going on here?
Yeah, was she Black Ops or some shit?
Yeah, so it's like freaking all of that kind of stuff, you know, revolving around Hawkeye's, but that really kind of set the stage for not only his character and stuff like that, but for her character going forward and knowing that freaking Hawk, that's why Hawkeye's never worried to go like handle business with that, because some shit were to pop off in his house. Like, I feel like Mama Bear is already gonna do what Mama Bears do and stuff like that, but she gonna whoop ass on another level and stuff like that, because she's not playing.
Did she have any kind of backstory like that in the comics?
In the comics, she just there. I can't say I remember so that. Some people were talking about Mockingbird and stuff like that, as far as like the fan theories and stuff go and stuff like that, but I'll be honest, I cannot remember Hawkeye's freaking. So, like, I have to ask my brother. My brother is more, way more. Hawkeye was one of his favorites with that. So, when I get a chance to talk to him, I'm going to get some clarity on that before, you know, we film episode 6. So,
I think we should get him. We should get him on here since he's an expert on Hawkeye. That would answer a lot of our questions. Unless he does do shenanigans.
I mean, he's Army. So, that.
He's founded on shenanigans.
Ooh. Yeah. Aren't ready for Marines yet? Really? All right.
Wow. But again, you guys wouldn't be you guys if you didn't do this kind of stuff. Anything else we don't really need to get on? We're about 16 minutes in. I feel like we're all pretty happy. We're all looking forward to a lot of good stuff moving on. Anything else, guys?
No, I'm just waiting to see these new costumes.
Yeah, I'm saying, I will say those lockers are hilarious, though. They're like the ultimate fanboys. They are great. They're right up there with the Tracksuit Mafia for me on secondary characters. They are. I love them.
Polka Dot Man, secondary character.
Huh?
What?
First of all, God damn it. Do not disrespect Ed McCreal. Told you about that. It was a heat.
Well, Grown and Geeks, it's been great. Check out the QR code. Be sure to hit that like button, hit that subscribe button. Be sure to leave your comments in the comment section. Let us know what we did wrong. Let us know what part of our shenanigans you appreciate. We have Ronan this bitch. Thank you for your time, man. Ms. Marvel Parker. Up top, the amazing Spider-Spam. Jabbing off screen. Tony, thank you for being on call.
I was doing my Hawkeye impersonation when you fight Daredevil.
Nah. Straight out of the chair. Tony.
Huh?
Hit us with the outro.
Polka Dot Man's favorite song is?
Yo, bust the ass.
Stomp by Kurt Cobain.